Hello and welcome to another Samfield Penstock Solutions training video. I'm looking today at our toggle block system. Just going to go through some of the simple operations of how to operate it. What you can see here is a 300mm toggle block valve. We've placed this in what we call the on-seated position, so the water is flowing in that direction, so it's going to be actually with the water will be aiding the pressure of the valve to seal. Can also go in the other orientation. What you have to remember is that when you put them in what they call the off-seating or the spill position, as I like to call it, that means the water is pushing the flap open, so you don't get so much control of the built-up head pressure. The 300mm valve is quite capable of taking a 3 metre head though, so it's a pretty significant amount of volume of liquid that can be contained. If you go for the firewall position like this, you're actually going for a complete dead stop, so you can control and put it into a firewall containment complete design set out probably in Syria 736. So what we've got here is a control panel, which is our battery operated solar or main, so they can be either or, just depends which one you want to use it for, whether the panel's going inside or outside. But this one here at the moment, battery powered, I haven't actually got any charge to it. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to close the valve. It's a simple press locally of the red button. So the valve now is closed. You'll see that we've got a red LED and you can hear a little sounder buzzing. That's just while it checks itself to make sure that it's actually reached the closed position. When it reaches the closed position, as you can see here, I've got a message now onto my mobile phone just telling me that the valve is now in the closed position. Just carry on doing that check a minute. That's it, it's finished now. What you could do now is you could effectively remove this control panel. That valve will remain in the locked position, so it will not open again. It'll stay in that position, so for a long time you'd have a locked containment valve. It'll only open once you apply a signal to open it. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to press the green button, which is the open button. See, now we've got a green LED. Green for go means the flow can go, red is flow stopped. Valve is opened, as you can see, and the flow will be going. This has got a drain down port on it, so it automatically drains down, because if you've got a large head of water, you can't really just go and release that when you've decided you want to open a valve. If you've had it shut for several days and you've got a lot of water behind it, you've got to release it slowly, or better still, remove it with a tanker and pump it out. That's the valve, how it works. So what I want to look now is automation. We get asked a lot of questions. In fact, a couple of weeks ago we asked about how we could simply automate our valve. It is really that simple. What I've done here is I've placed a float switch, so you could have this in a sump. So if you were a site that had a effluent treatment process and you maybe had a sump in the ground, that if it did rise up and overflow would potentially reach the surface water network. So what we've got here is a float that could be used. What the inquiry we had last week was that the site had got a sump. What they wanted to do was they'd already got a toggle box system on their drainage network, the surface water drain. There was a manhole that actually is in the effluent treatment plant process area. So what they wanted to do was that if the effluent treatment plant sump ever filled up, the valve would automatically close. It sends a signal to tell them they've got a fault now on their effluent treatment plant as well. But it's extra protection so that nothing could get across and be some contamination issues from a problem with the effluent treatment plant. So simply the float, normally open switch, turn it into a closed switch. Valve is now activated, closed, we've got the red LED, it's just doing its check, which is why you can hear the bleeper going at the moment. If I look on my phone, the phone's just come through now as a signal to say that the valve is closed from the alarm. So I'll just let that finish doing its check. Right, so now that's done its check, it sent its message, so it's completely closed and locked off. I cannot open the valve whilst I have an alarm message on the float. So whilst that alarm message is there, you cannot open that valve. You have to look at what's caused the pollution incident and sort it out. You can't just override the system. You could if you disconnected it, but I think that'd be a rather foolish thing to do. So what we've got now is, let's say we've cleaned out the sump, we've got rid of it. We're now safe to release the valve. We've looked, we've checked. Simple, press the button. The valve is now going into the open position. Just wait for the LED. It's doing its checks. It's just checking to see that it's in the right position. These valves actually know whether they are closed and actually whether they are open. It's now satisfied that it's in the open position. It's given us a confirmation. Sound has gone off. If there had been a fault, what we'd have had was an amber light here and the system would have stayed in alarm. Okay, thanks for watching. If you've got any questions, why don't you visit our website, which is www.penstocksolutions.co.uk, or better still, get in touch and give us a call. Cheers, thanks a lot. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.